Hello, everyone. My name is Rick Jenkins, and I'm the publisher at GSA Business Report, and we are the media company that serves high-level business executives in the upstate of South Carolina. And welcome to another episode of 120 Seconds. This is where I go 2 minutes talking to a business community leader, basically about whatever's on my mind, but we do it in 2 minutes. One business leader, 2 minutes, no bull. Well, maybe a little bit of bull. Today, I'm talking with Keith Miller. Dr. Miller is the president of Greenville Technical College. Dr. Miller, welcome.
Good morning. Thanks for the opportunity.
Good to see you. I appreciate you coming over. I know you got to be very busy, so thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome. Pleased to be here.
We'll get started with Dr. Miller in just a second, but first, we want to hear from our partner, PeopleSurge, and they're sponsoring this series, 120 Seconds. Let's see what those guys have to say.
Today's business leaders struggle to find good people that are the right fit for their organization. They're searching for ways to develop future leaders, and they're curious about how to build a winning culture.
So PeopleSurge, our mission is to help organizations build the confidence that they need to build those cultures. And we do that through a combination of science, data, and 30 years of experience being CEOs and business owners.
All right, welcome back. Thanks again to our partner, PeopleSurge. And Dr. Miller, are you ready to go?
I'm ready.
All right, we're going to do 120 seconds. That's 2 minutes, if you didn't know, with Dr. Keith Miller. Guys, give me a bell and let's go. Dr. Miller, where are you from?
Small farming community in central Kansas.
What's it called?
Hoisington, Kansas.
Born and raised?
Born and raised there, yes.
Where'd you get your education?
Kansas State University was my PhD, but I also attended the University of Kansas and started out at a community college, though, at Hutchinson, Kansas.
At Hutchinson. Now, Kansas State's the Wildcats, Kansas is the Jayhawks.
Correct.
I'm from Kentucky. It means I don't like either one. Let's move on. You came to Greenville Tech in 2008. What was the first time? Was that the first time you'd ever been in Greenville?
Other than the interview and the recruiting trip that convinced us to come here. Yes.
You love Greenville.
Absolutely love it. Progressive community.
In your prior job, you were the president at Blackhawk College. Where is that?
Blackhawk College is in Moline, Illinois. It's about 3.5 hours southwest, I believe it is, of Chicago, home to international headquarters for John Deere.
Got it. Hey, that's a pretty good piece of trivia right there. Did they name the helicopter after the college?
No, I don't believe so.
Did they name the college after the helicopter?
Neither one.
Okay, good. When was Greenville Tech founded?
1962.
You're the second president there. Who was the first?
The first is Tom Barton, Dr. Tom Barton. He was there for 46 years. He started the college.
You're going to be there 46 years?
I don't think I will make 46 years.
What's the current enrollment?
The current enrollment on an annual basis is just under 15,000 students. And that's actually, in a way, a little bit misleading. It's those students and college credit courses, and we have another 10,000 in non-credit.
Got it. That's a lot. What is Adventure Tech? Tell me about that.
Adventure Tech are camps, mostly for middle-aged, school-aged children. Examples are culinary and 3D printing, but that can vary from year to year.
My favorite thing that Greenville Tech does is CMI. Tell me what that stands for.
CMI is Center for Manufacturing Innovation. Of course, our biggest employer base is manufacturing, and CMI is there to serve them.
We're going to keep going just for a minute. What do you do in your spare time?
Play golf.
Play golf. What's your favorite cocktail?
Woodford Reserve.
Ah, I love Woodford Reserve. It's distilled in Woodford County, about 10 miles from my house in Kentucky. Yeah. What is your favorite business publication in the upstate?
Well, there's only one.
That's right. And what is it?
That's GSA.
Oh, I love it. I love it. Clemson or South Carolina?
It depends on who's asking and what's at stake.
Good answer. Dr. Miller, thank you.
You're welcome.
That was 120 seconds or 2 minutes and a little change with Dr. Keith Miller, who is the president of Greenville Technical College. Dr. Miller, once again, thank you for joining us. But we do have one more question, and it is going to come from our sponsor again, our partners at PeopleSurge, and Mike Mosel, who is the co-founder of PeopleSurge, has one more question for you. Mike, what do you got?
How is the school operating now during the challenges of COVID-19?
Mike, thanks. That is a good question. Dr. Miller, COVID, tough times, man. Challenging. What's going on?
It is challenging. Of course, it's challenging for anybody and at any level of education. But, you know, two-year colleges were created primarily with an eye towards flexibility. And that of course characterizes Greenville Technical College. Yes, it's been a challenge. Don't let me underestimate that at all. But because that is part of our culture, because part of that is our history, we've been able to turn on a dime. We've been able to put all those courses online with the exception of some lab courses and stuff. But you know, we made those work too with bringing in small groups of students, disinfecting labs in between the small groups of students. So we made that work, and we plan right now to be back in full operation. We're in full operation now, and not just in terms of the courses, but in terms of student support services. Those are all virtual. Tutoring, everything is virtual right now. August 24th starts our fall semester. We will be back. We will be open as we usually have been, but the students will have more choices then. They'll be able to attend face-to-face. Courses, they'll be able to enroll in hybrid courses, which is partly face-to-face and partly virtual, or 100% virtual courses. And of course, we've done all the things that you've heard about and that you know about in terms of preparing our classrooms, preparing the labs, putting up plexiglass barriers, removing different pieces of furniture and that type of thing. So we're open for business. We're ready to go.
I'm sure the students cannot wait to get back. If they're like my kids, they just want to get back into the swing of things like we all do. Dr. Miller, thank you so much. I appreciate you. That concludes another episode of 120 Seconds. If you want to see more episodes, check out our YouTube page where we also have plenty of other video series that you'll enjoy, I'm sure. We'll see you next time.